thumbnails. If you've watched any YouTube growth enthusiast, you'll know that it's an important part of getting people to click on your videos to watch. YouTube themselves even recommend having a captivating title that teases what your video is about. I myself have evolved my thumbnail making abilities from when I first started to now. I found a style that I like to work with that teases the subject of the video and is enticing enough to make me want to click. I was watching Jax Films videos when I was inspired by his video on remaking thumbnails of other people's videos when I thought, I can do that too. Roll the intro. That's not the right intro. My name is Anton Wong. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here on this channel, I'm here to unleash the power of video. So if you haven't yet, hit subscribe. And by the way, if it sounds like I am speaking with a ton of rocks in my mouth, it's because I have a bunch of canker sores inside my mouth and it's driving me crazy. So just bear with me. It hurts so much to talk.
Oh my goodness.
Now the point of making this challenge was to just practice making thumbnails for different kinds of videos that aren't my own and just hone my craft of making thumbnails. I don't claim to be an expert on thumbnails, and the ones I'll be making will be a combination of my style and elements of how I project. They might like it, like, you know, if they were my client. So if you're a big fan of them, just know that I am doing this for practice and not because I think I'm better than anyone. I just thought I'd point that out because there are some pretty intense internet fans out there. So I figured I'd start this off with the man who inspired this challenge, John Douglas. I mean, Jax Films. I found that the Aaron Show video that he did with his wife was very funny, but it didn't have a very interesting thumbnail compared to his other stuff. So I scrubbed through and found two moments where I thought each of their faces would be funny, and I screen capped them. In Photoshop, I started with my 920 by 1080 pixel template and imported the images. I drew a mask around each of them using the object selection tool, and I adjusted the mask with the quick selection tool. And once I was happy with it, I applied a feather to the mask and created a layer mask of each of them. They needed a background, so I just grabbed a Jax Films usual background from Google Images and applied a Gaussian blur. It's not that great, but I ended up changing this later. I figured it would be funny to change the colors of their faces to something that would stand out. And that's how I got to this. And similar to his other thumbnails, I used Liquify to warp and exaggerate their features and expressions. Now Jack's glasses, if you can see, had some glare, so I had to hastily clone stamp his other eye. But you know what? The jank really adds to the effect. I was gonna make his forehead bigger because of the whole, you know, running joke of him, you know, having a big forehead, but I didn't want him to seem big brain, and that wasn't the look I was going for. I warped Aaron's face and then slapped them both with a white stroke outline and drop shadow. I separated them with a green border just because in the video they were separated. I added Comic Sans text with wide kerning, and because I didn't like the background, I swapped it out for a screen cap from their stereo conversation, and here's the result. Boom! Fix your thumbnail, next thumbnail! That's something he does in his videos. I thought it would be funny. Next, I decided to work on another funny boy, Gus Johnson, or Bus Jackson. He's got a video with Ian Kung about repeating yourself to your friends, and I had an idea for a good thumbnail. First, I screen capped a couple of different faces of Gus and Ian together, as well as Gus alone. Then in Photoshop, I brought in a photo of Gus and Ian and duplicated the layer before creating a mask of the two, then blurring out the background. I then brought in some more layers of Gus and layer masked those two. I moved around other photos of Gus around the border of the frame and duplicated him a bunch of times to illustrate the idea of having to repeat yourself. I avoided the bottom right because that's usually where the time marker is, and as you can see, I did that for all the other following thumbnails and all of my thumbnails in general. I adjusted the brightness and curves to some of the photos to make them pop and seem more consistent. I added a stroke and outer glow to the main image and added a thinner stroke and drop shadow for the smaller images. I then added some text with a stroke and drop shadow before making some adjustments. Here it is. I think it's pretty good, but on to the next one. I figure I would leave the comedy space for a little bit and enter the science and education space. My friend Travis from Curious Tangents and I worked previously on a video together on his channel about how videos manipulate us using different techniques. Thought the thumbnail was okay, but could use some work, like including me in it. Come on, Travis, like, why wasn't I included in the thumbnail? Anyway, it's okay. So I went and recorded a couple of seconds of me menacingly looking into my camcorder and pulled a frame that I liked. I brought that into Photoshop and masked myself along with Travis. It took me a while to settle on a background that I liked. I wanted to keep with this hypnotic swirl theme, but first I adjusted my face to make it redder and more contrasty and boosted Travis's exposure. I liquefied my face to make it seem more cartoonishly evil and swirled Travis's eyes to make him seem hypnotized. I added two swirly circles around his eyes and lowered the opacity. I settled on a blurred background of a YouTube homepage with a blurred hypnotic swirl over it with a lowered opacity. I added a white strobe and outer glow for Travis and a red one for me just to make me seem even more devilish. I added some text and boom, there's the final thumbnail. I'm looking a little cursed there, literally cursed. Okay, there's too many dudes in this. So let's get back to comedy with some funny woman, specifically a very funny woman, Julie Nolke. She's got this series with her character, Drunk Mirror Julie, and I think that would make for a good thumbnail. The rest of her videos are mostly just stills from the video, and like, that's most of her thumbnails, so I thought I would make something a little bit more clickable. So I snapped some screenshots of her and Mirror Julie and masked each of them. I was thinking of using a background that illustrates amnesia, but there was a joke where she keeps talking about the Fast and the Furious movies, so I grabbed a promo photo from one of the Fast and Furious movies, blurred it, and made that the background. I was torn on how to do the outlines of each of them until I settled on Mirror Julie having a white stroke with a drop shadow, and the other Julie having a dark stroke with a brighter outer glow. I adjusted the tone curves for each of them to brighten up the contrast and exposure. I put a piece of text and boom, I think it works well because, you know, it's got a little bit of the clicky style, but still simple enough to be consistent with Julie's style. Speaking of Julie, I thought I'd also do one of her friends, Christian and Nat, who are a very funny couple with not enough subscribers. For their thumbnail, I also wanted to keep it simple. There's this one sketch titled Our Deepest Fears that I felt could work for a good thumbnail. Once again, I screenshotted some moments from the video and then brought them into Photoshop to mess them out. For the background, I ended up finding a dark black and white photo of a dark streak. I found a speech bubble to use for Christian and put the text in there. This time I tried giving them a white border stroke, but it just didn't seem that good against the dark background, so I ended up just going with a bright outer glow. I brightened up their faces and with some curves and some tone curves, and boom, another one. The final one I did is of Jade Vincent, who I made a YouTube intro for back in my past video, switching to DaVinci Resolve for 30 days. I noticed that her thumbnails could use a little bit of pizzazz, so I grabbed screenshots of her and her friend Maggie from one of her vlogs and masked them out as per usual. For background, I went with a Calgary city skyline since they were vlogging in downtown Calgary. I outlined them with a white stroke and outer glow before brightening each of them up. I added text before getting way too carried away with a liquify tool to make some truly cursed images. Boom. So at the end of this challenge, what did I learn? Nothing. Okay, bye. Okay, I learned some things. One of the things I learned was just the variety of different styles of thumbnails there are. Another thing I learned was how to keep in mind the target audience when making these thumbnails. I didn't want the style to be misleading at all, but wanted it to be accurate to the tone and type of video the thumbnail was for. Also, the Photoshop liquify tool is hilarious. And if you'd like to check out my previous challenges, you can click right over here. And do let me know what other YouTube thumbnails and YouTubers' thumbnails you would like me to remake in a possible part 2. Let me know down in the comments. If you like this video, be sure to hit like and share it with your friends because it just took me so much. My mouth is just on fire with all these canker sores, so just please like the video for me, please. But with that out of the way, I'll just see you guys in another video. Take care.